वेलकम जी। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व वन वेरी बेसिक इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चन। द क्वेश्चन इज दैट फाइंड द फैक्टोरियल ऑफ गिवन नंबर। सो यू नो व्हाट आर द फैक्टोरियल? फैक्टोरियल इज ऑफ एनी नंबर। फैक्टोरियल मीन्स यू आर जस्ट मल्टीप्लाई एन नंबर, नंबर माइनस वन, नंबर माइनस टू, नंबर माइनस थ्री, नंबर माइनस फोर अंटिल वन। दैट इज द फैक्टोरियल ऑफ गिवन एनी नंबर। Okay, so for example, if you are taking example, if you are taking an example of 5, minus 5 multiplied by 4 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 2, that would be 120. So factorial of so we have to write in any function that take input n and that return as a factorial of f. So we have to n multiply by n minus 1 multiply by n minus 2. This way we have to return the result. And now the solution perspective, I am going to discuss the four approaches you can solve these questions. First, using normal for loop simple solution, and second, the recursive solution. And sometime recursive solution for the factorial number might be some, if you are pushing the high value of factorial 100, 200, your this recursive function throughout of stack overflow. So for saving our exception, take the proper output, we have used the concept of tail recursive. Tail recursive used for the generating a long factorial number. And third approach I am discussing about using the lambda expression, how functional programming in Java we can write this factorials program. So let us write a code. So first I am going to write a very simple way. I am going to check to real given number. So we have to whenever you are calculating these two number, we have to hold some variable, then the result, then this. You can 4 multiply by 5 multiply by 4 20, then 20 multiply by 3, then two, then multiply for the result. We have to take one variable like a factorial, initially value 1, and after that take a loop until number greater than 0. We have to factorial equal to factorial multiply by your number, and then your number equal to number minus 1, and finally we just return this factorial. So this is the way you can just check the solution. We have taken input number 5 and out if we call about the factorial, if we passing this input number along and input, and if you run this program, so you are getting output 120 as per expected. So what the logic here? Here input 5 with the 5 here come, okay, f equal to 1, then n greater than 0, 5 greater than 0, then you have a factorial 1 multiply by your 5, okay, then number equal to number minus 1, number become 4, then next loop, okay, 4 greater than 0, 4 greater than 0, then this is the 5 factorial 5, and 5 multiply by 4 equal to 1, 20, 120, and number equal to your number minus 1, 3. And then again while loop, number is equal to 3, and your factorial is equal to 20. Fill factorial multiply by 20 multiply by 3, and that is your 60. Your number equal to again number minus 1, you have a 2. Then next while loop, 2 greater than 0, 2 greater than 0, then factorial multiply by number, factorial 60, 60 multiply by 2, number 1, again 60 multiply by 2, number 1 greater than 0, greater than 0, factorial multiply by n, 120 multiply by 1, and then we do and n number minus 1 return 0, n greater than 0, no, then return bar and out, return factorial is equal to 120. So here you can return 120. If you greater than 1, you can also check. If you write here greater than 1, it's also work. Okay. Okay, so this is the one of the basic way to writing the code in okay. If someone ask write the same code in a recursive way, how will do? Okay, so any function, if taking input n and they are doing some logic, and after that they are invoking the same function again. Okay, the same function again, that is a recursive function. Why? The same set of logic I want to perform again, so we have to do recursive call. Here what have to we are frequently multiply by for number minus number 2, number 3, number 4, so we can achieve through recursive as well as. So how to write this? Let's write static long factorial recursive long input here. So how for any recursive functions, whenever whenever this function input n, you are calling from here fn n, and then here we have to apply some breakpoint from where the function will break. If you are not applying any break condition, this function become infinite. This function come, do something, invoke the same function, do something, invoke the same function, do something, invoke the same function. So on this input basis, we have to apply some check condition from where the code is the break from the loop. So first I have to apply the break condition. If your number double equal to n, then return the number itself. Okay, else if number not greater than 1, then number multiply by again factorial number minus 1. So this way you are able to calculate factorial using the recursive function. If you run it and you notice, this is your output. Okay, so in the factorial what happened, whenever your input number n, for if number not equal to 1, if number is 5, if for example this is a 5 number not equal to 1, then go else and invoke number 5 multiply by your factorial. Again invoke this function for n minus 1, 4. Okay, means your function again invoke this function again invoke for 4. If 4 equal to 1, no, then again go 4 multiply by again invoke function for 3. You are again invoke the same function for 3 input. 3 not equal to 1, then again 3 multiply by factorial 3 minus 2, 2. Then again 2, 2 not equal to n, no, again 2 multiply by factorial 1, again invoke function 1, n equal to 1, n equal to 1, then return number 1, then return number 1, this is n number written, where written here. Okay, the 2 multiply by 1, 2, 1. Then again, after the completion of this function, return value here. 3, again, here, 3 multiply by 2 multiply by 1. After that, this return again, F3. Then, this calculate. Then, after this calculation again, return F4 value here. Then, complete value calculated. Then, this complete value returned to your output. So, if for each if number for each name there is one method is take invoke, what happen if your this number input number is huge, like 15,100, 200, you have your 200 functions are invoke, okay, all are waiting for your result computation. So your chance that you are facing the out of stack overflow. So if your input number is very long, your number of stack created as per your input number, and you have a limited memory for running your application, so you are facing a Java out of stack memory. So why? Because all these stacks are waiting to return the calculated value for the 4 multiply by the function of 5 multiply by the function of 4. Until function of 4 value is not returned, they are waiting for block. Similarly this waiting. So to solve this problem, we come up with the concept of tail recursive. Tail recursive say last up factorial ka last operation only the factorial recursive call. This calculation should not happen the last call. If this is not happening, then callback recursive is not required. So how to avoid this? If I am to write this code, static long factorial fact, long input here, instead of I just condition breakpoint, if number double equal to 1, then the return number itself, else return factorial n minus 1, and we have to take another this variable which we are holding on the temporary base, take a parameter argument and integer your factorial. Here we pass factorial multiply by your number. Okay, so factorial is another function, a factorial fact. Okay, what say? Okay, this is your long, and down neck static just long static long factorial re tail recursive. Tail recursive. Tail recursive. You have a long n number. Here you just return your the tail recursive. Tail recursion. Tail recursion. Pass your number and your functional identity value 1. Initially, you have a okay. If you run tail recursion. If you run it, you will get the same output. Missing return statement. Okay, here. Return. Now, yes, compiled code and output would be 1. Why initially this should be I pass factorial n greater than 0, then return. This is fact. Return your calculated factorial and not the value, not the number. You have to return the calculated factorial if number is equal to n hold. What this just okay. So this f hold the calculated value. Whenever number is equal to 1, they return the calculated value. How happen? Let's see. If your number 5 pass 5 equal to 1, no, call again function. Is this function call what? This is the number minus 1 4. F initially we pass 1, the 1 multiply by 5, 1 multiply by 5. Okay, then then same function invoke here. Now number is equal to 4. 4 equal to 1, no, then invoke function here 3, and then here 5 multiply by 4. Okay, then invoke function. This is a 3 calculated value, f value 20. 3 equal to 1, no, then again invoke function f. You have a 2, you have for 20, 20 multiply by 3, again invoke function for function invoke 2, for 2 you 3 to just 60. 60 invoke again function invoke 1, and here equal to 60 multiply by 2, and then again invoke your function f 1 comma 1, then f 1 return factorial. What is the factorial value? Yeah, 620. Then 620 return. The here from this function call itself, you are returning the result, not coming back this function, not coming back this function, not coming back this function. Due to that, tail recursive is avoid save our out of stack memory. Okay, and you tail recursive same here. What you are doing here, f equal to 1, f equal to 1, then calculating f multiply by n f multiply by I. You are just checking nn minus 1 1. This is the nn minus 1. Just the way of writing code different way. This code and this code work the same. tail recursion say whenever you are calling any tail recursive function, your last call of the recursive call should be only recursive call, not depend upon the any calculation. So this is the calculation enforce recursive call, wait for a callback. Here we are just avoiding those callback returns. Okay, so this way you can generally whenever you are going to write a code in a tail recursive instead of pen recursive, you are saving your stack memory. Okay, let us solve this same question using factorial using lambda. So we are here return, we are taking the long number, so we have a long string, we have just iterate number from initially number 1 until number not equal to 0, next number equal to number minus 1, 1 1 minus come, then just reduce this function and we have to pass identity function. For factorial we have identity function 1, then we have a your function factorial and the number. What we are doing is factorial multiply by your number. It's in this way you are if you run this program again, this factorial and using your lambda expression here, using lambda I pass your input, you would get the same result. Here we will get the same. So let's look how this work. Okay, so here you note what we're doing. We are just a given input number, we are iterating from this number until number not equal to 0. Okay, for each iteration you are just going number minus 1. For what thing? Initially reducing it with help of identity function 1, and this is the function 1 and this is the input number. Okay, so let's see, if you are passing here 5, they start 5, then this I start from 5 not equal to 0, yes, here what doing 1 multiply by 5, then check again number is equal to 4, n minus 1, 4, not equal to 0, not equal to 0, again this f become, this calculated value is the f again, this is the 5 multiply by number equal to 4, 520, 20, again invoking of number n minus 1 is equal to 3, again 3 here come, so again your calculated factorial 20 multiply by your 3 to the 60, 4 again number, here again come number minus 1, 2, here again 60 multiply by 2 equal to 120, it's got number equal to not equal to 0, not equal to 0, again what you do 120 multiply by 1, again invoking in minus 1, 0, not equal to 0, yes 0, then break, then this result to have to return. So this way here you can write the number not equal to 1 itself, because 1 is an extra call. If you run it, okay, the simple way. So this is the way you are able to write the code using the lambda expression. If you look the code here in the simple way, what you are doing here, you are doing initialization, some extra variable, some modification those variable, and return the calculations. Here you are not initializing any extra variable, you are not doing any modification, all are the run at the method invocation only, and you are getting the same result. This code is your can be candidate for your multi-thread. If you want to run this code in multi-threaded environment, this run, they are not they are only depend upon the input, else are not. But if you see, I can write this code is thread safe, you cannot say this code is thread safe. Lots of either plus minus multiplication help. If someone asks, you can write code in a multi-threading environment, you have to think, you have to write the separate way to wait and synchronize the method. Here we have just simple, this is one method dot parallel stream, and pipe, you can just start your multi-threading environment as well. As so if you write the code using the lambda expression, the concept, if follow the concept of functional programming, that help us to write a code in your more basically more pure function. Okay, so whenever you are going to write any solve any interview questions, are you writing any business logic, do you think we are able to achieve that goal using the functional style or not? If we are able to do the code in functional style, you try to write those codes in the functional style. That help you to learn how the lambda expression used in the functional programmings. And do you, if you are using the functional program, your code is become a one-liner and a more concise way, and you are not creating an extra variable, you are not mutating any variables as well. As your code is pure, your method become a pure function. Any method a pure functions, that is good candidate for your multi-threading or your parallel processing, yeah, parallel programming as well. As so hope it help you how you think your code can be converted from normal your iterative way with your with the lambda expression as well. As so if you do practice to writing a code in the lambda expression, as many as you do practice to write your all the algorithm logic using lambda expressions, you feel confident whenever you are writing code in applications. You familiar with the lambda expression, you can write a code using lambda expression is in your application as well. As okay, hope it will be useful for you. Thank you for watching this video.